Hello. Today, we'll look at how you can create quizzes, tests, and worksheets in Auralia and Musician. Before we start, tests are sequences of questions that teachers can create for their students and classes. Teachers use tests in many different ways. Quizzes, weekly worksheets, assessments and exams, and customised learning tasks. If you link Auralia and Musician to your learning management system, such as Canvas, Moodle or Blackboard, your test results will flow back into your gradebook automatically. It's a big time saver. In both Auralia and Musician, we include loads of tests for you. These cover AP Music Theory, Band, Jazz, and of course General Ear Training and Music Theory. You can assign any of these to your students, as we'll show you later in this video. Many teachers like to create their own tests, ensuring that their students are covering content that is relevant to their current areas of study. We've chosen tests on the main screen, and now we'll create a simple oral test one. We enter the name and description for our test. There are a number of options below, but we'll come back to these later. First, we'll put some content into our new test. Choose the Entries button. And now, create a new entry. You'll see that there are three types available. Level drills use randomly selected questions from any syllabus and topic, including levels that you may have created in your own syllabus. Library drills draw from the audio and notation in the question library, giving you the power to control the exact content that your students will be presented with. We always recommend using library drills for formal assessments and exams. And lastly, display text entries are very simple. You can add some text that is shown to your students during their task. Our first entry will be a level drill. We're going to choose chord recognition. We choose the syllabus, topic, level, number of questions, and number of marks for the entry. Notice the level description. This provides more detail about content as you browse the topics and levels. Our second entry will be a library drill. We'll give this a title, melodic dictation, set one question to be asked, and then we'll select our questions. The library has thousands and thousands of questions. You can browse through, but it's a lot simpler to search. Let's find a Mozart melodic dictation question in 3-4. You don't have to rely on the question descriptions. You can preview the question right on this screen. And now we can add it to our list. We'll also add two more melodic dictation questions while we're on this screen. Back on the test editing screen, we can now see our three chosen questions. But if you remember, when I created this entry, I set one question to be asked. By having more questions than required, I've created a question bank. Each student will do one of the three questions, and they'll be chosen randomly for each of our students. If a topic has playback, generally in Auralia, you can modify the number of plays that the student is allowed. You can also choose if the playback is started automatically and if the student can pause the playback during the question. Very handy for longer examples. You can continue to add as many entries as required. We'll add just one more, harmonic dictation using a library question. Let's assign our new test to some of our students. Select the classes that you wish to take this test. When the students next log in, your oral test 1 will be available on their home screen. When your Auralia and Musician service is integrated with your school LMS, results will automatically flow back to your gradebook, and tests are always assigned to classes within that system. If you would like to preview the test, you can simply select the play button right on this screen. Let's now work through some settings and options. The time slot feature is absolutely invaluable when using cloud. It's very common to set a finishing time or due date for the task. This has two benefits. It keeps students focused, and importantly, it means that once the finishing time has passed, the teacher can run reports, knowing that no more results can be added. Many teachers allow their students to take tests multiple times, especially if they are worksheets. The results from each attempt are stored separately. When you look at the reports, there are numerous ways you can view these results: best attempt, worst attempt, or combined attempts. The navigation and review option allows students to answer questions in any order and review their answers prior to submission. It's great for assessments and exams. Note that you must use library drills to enable this feature. There are various other options that are dependent on the type of task you are creating: a quick quiz, worksheet, or high stakes exam. Feedback can be disabled, results can be hidden, and you can allow your students to exit before finishing and resume their test later if necessary. That completes our tutorial on tests and worksheets. Now that you know how to create and assign these tasks, the next step is learning how to view the results. You'll find a training video covering results and reports on our website. Thanks for watching.